Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got a book review for you today. This one is not going to be popular. That's all right, though, because, hey, you know what? I gotta say, you know, what the truth is. And it's unfortunate because I actually wanted to like this book, and I wanted it to be really good. And there are some things that are good about this book, but overall, my opinion and impression of the book and really of the man behind the book, unfortunately, is not extremely positive. So this book is called Headstrong, and it's by Dave Asprey. And, you know, I've had mixed thoughts about what this guy's recommended, and you know, I realized that this guy is a pretty successful dude, and that he's probably had some success with what he's doing. You know, he's the Bulletproof Coffee guy. I've tried Bulletproof Coffee. I've not seen a huge benefit from it. I still don't quite understand the full benefit that you're supposed to get from it. You know, obviously it's detailed in that book, but yeah. So let's talk about this book a little bit here. So the book is really interesting. It is really focused on one thing, which is increasing your mitochondria health and production. The basis of all of what Dave is saying in this book is that everything that happens biologically within you really comes down to mitochondria. Now, I think this is somewhat of an oversimplification, and I think having your mitochondria work as efficiently as possible does not necessarily guarantee overall health benefits. I think that in any kind of complex system, that working on one component does not necessarily guarantee results in the rest of the system. As anyone who has created unit tests as a software developer knows, this is true, right? You can unit test the hell out of things. You can make certain things or lines of code super efficient and they could work well, but when you combine them together and see them in the bigger system, it doesn't mean that they work, and it doesn't mean that you don't have to do system and integration level testing. So I think the same thing is going on here, but gosh, I have mixed thoughts on this. There's some things in the book that I feel like maybe I need to research a little bit more and see if this is accurate or not, and there's a lot of other stuff that I'm just like, this is just too over the top and really trying to sell these supplements and the stuff that Dave has created. Now, I don't know on some of the stuff. I probably would purchase some of the stuff from him. I've bought, I just wanted to tell you, say this so that you know I'm not a hater. I've bought his protein bars. They're friggin' awesome. The collagen protein bars, those are delicious. They're awesome and they're good, and it's a good profile of exactly what I'd want in a protein bar for a ketogenic or low carbohydrate diet. So he does produce some good stuff. I'm not so sure on the coffee stuff. I'm not so sure, right, in this book he talks about the mold and the coffee, and I'm sure that's a thing. I'm not sure how much it matters for the peripherals, or however they're said, but I don't know. I feel like enough of the book is a sales pitch, and there's nothing wrong with selling something in a book. I mean, hell, in my books, I sell shit. In my newest book, I'll be selling a lot, right? I mean, there'll be a lot of sales pitches. You can check out my Complete Software Developer's Career Guide if you haven't signed up already. Go there to buy it or watch the trailer or sign up if it hasn't released. It should be releasing July 19th, so it might already be out by the time you're watching this video. But I have no problem with selling stuff. It's just that it's the way that you sell something as, you know, I can't even describe the way that it's rubbing me the wrong way in this book. I would say that the problem with it is that it's promoting this stuff that is not necessarily accurate and giving sort of a false hope. I know that sounds really generic. You kind of have to read the book to really get what I'm saying here, but I don't like it. I don't like the way that the stuff is promoted. I can't trust it. I guess that's what I'm saying is trust is not being conveyed here by the way that that's happening. The other thing about the book that really disturbs me, and maybe about Dave in general, and I, as much as I hate to say this because I haven't met the guy, he's probably really, really cool guy, but the way that he's come across in this book and what he's saying is he's basically blaming all of his problems on mitochondria problems, right? So he's saying I couldn't concentrate in my MBA, I got fat, right, because of mold and that caused me mitochondria problems, and I had Asperger's or it was socially awkward because of that, and I got angry all the time. And that's so, again, I probably wouldn't even do this review except that message is so damn counterintuitive to the message that I have on this channel. And granted, that's the whole point, right? So I know that a lot of you are Dave Asprey fans. That's great. That's awesome. But I'm going to speak the truth here. And I feel like his way of blaming all of his fucking problems in life on his mitochondria deficiencies is just a cop-out fucking answer for life. And it may be true that he has mitochondrial deficiencies. It may be true that some things weren't firing right and that by doing all this biohacking, he's been able to bring that level up. But that may be true, but that's still not an excuse. That's still not a reason. I don't want to. It's the victim mentality. It's going back and saying, oh yeah, you know, if everything was right. And it's giving other people the permission, right? He's almost saying in the book, like, you know what? You're fucked up and you got all the problems, right? You got anger problems, you're overweight, you got all this, you don't have energy, you can't concentrate, all these problems, it's your mitochondria. And not only is it your mitochondria, it's not your fault, it's your mitochondria's fault, but I'm gonna show you how to fix it just by my shit. And I just can't get on board with that, right? I can totally get on the board with the message of buy my shit. Totally, right? I sell a ton of stuff here, right? I mean, you can go and check out my products and you can see all the products on Simple Programmer. I sell a lot of stuff, okay? But it's to empower you, not to give you an excuse for why you're fucked up, right? The reason why you're fucked up is because you're not applying yourself, is because you are a lazy asshole, okay? You're angry because you have a character deficiency, right? You're treating people shitty because you are shitty, okay? And not at your core, you don't mean to do that, but what I'm saying is that, like, you need to accept responsibility and to not blame it, not try to look for an excuse. Yes, your mitochondria may not be firing as efficiently as possible. That's great. And maybe you can improve that. And I hope that you do. And I hope that Dave Asprey helps you find that the way to do that. And I'm going to gather some stuff from the book that I hope will help me. Honestly, I'm going to go through it and try to take what I can. But there's so much stuff to sort through and so much burden that's in this book that I can't trust it. Now, and that brings me to the other problem I have with the book. It's like all of this stuff, like you can't do all these things. It's ridiculous. It's like ridiculous, and like living your life to try and optimize your mitochondria is just friggin' ridiculous, especially with all the stuff that he outlines in here. And some of it is really damn kooky. And you know, and me, again, I embrace a lot of kooky shit. I really do. But it's effective. At least I've tested out and found out. So it's really hard for me to say this. You know, to almost. I mean, I feel like when I'm making this review, I'm being that it's hypocritical. Like hypocrisy almost, that it'll be perceived that way, simply because you're saying, well, John, you sell a bunch of shit. John, you sell your stuff. You promote yourself in your book. You talk about all this kind of crazy medical and health stuff. But I'm the friggin', but I eat my own dog food and I'm the proof of it by the means that you can measure, right? I mean, when he says that his cognitive ability is increased and all this stuff, and he's like taking all these things while he's writing the book, I'm not impressed. I'm not seeing anything. But when I'm giving you fitness advice and I'm like, look, I actually do have fucking six pack abs, and look, I actually am running 40 miles a week. That's a little bit more conclusive in my mind. It's more conclusive. It's more provable, right? It's like, yes, this is actually happening, and I'm not really even selling you something on that. Although maybe I will in the future when I do my program. So, what can I say? What can I say about the book? I don't know if it's even worth the read, to be honest with you. Like, again, I don't want to hate on anyone, and I'm sure that Dave is a great guy. I'm sure if we met, we'd get along really well. But I don't like the victim mentality premise of the book. I don't like the fact that it's pushing stuff that I really cannot say are going to have a big benefit, that it really matters that much. And you know, I've seen some of the blog posts that the dude has done, and you know, going back and looking at it, and it's like, hey, I've been eating, you know, 4,000 calories a day for the last 2 years, and I have a six pack. And I'm like, yeah, but what about the fucking hormone replacement therapy? What about that? You didn't fucking mention that in the blog post, and that's obviously what's going on. I mean, dude, you're 40, right? You're not working out, and he says he hasn't worked out in 2 years. I'm like, you don't, like, it just, I know this doesn't happen, right? I know this, so it's completely deceptive. It's bullshit, right? So, I mean, maybe I'm executing the whole thing that Nicholas Taleb, whatever, you know, what he says in Anti-Fragile or Black Swan, where he says, If you see fraud and you don't cry fraud, you're a fraud. I guess I'm executing that here because it's fraud. That's bullshit when you're making those kind of claims and that kind of stuff. And yeah, maybe this is not going to be the best video for my image. Maybe a lot. There's a huge overlap in my audience with Dave Asprey. And, you know, maybe that'll put a nice target on my head. I don't give a fuck. You know what? It's the truth is the truth, and that's what it is. And you feel free to disagree with me. Hell, if you read the book and there's like tons of shit that I'm missing here, let me know. I'll be glad to hear it. But it sounds like a load of bullshit to me, honestly. That's it. And I hardly ever say that. I hardly call people shit bullshit because I hate that. I hate when people do it to me, okay? And I hate when people do it in general to knock someone. But I got to give you an honest review here and tell you this sounds like a load of bullshit here. And there's a few things that I'll probably extract from it that probably have some truth to it. But for the most part, man, I have to give this one a thumbs down. If you like this review, if you don't like this review, if you just want to see what else I'm going to do, click that subscribe button below. Click the bell so you don't miss any videos. I will talk to you next time. Take care.